how to have glass skin. 5 tips I haven't told you yet. And there's probably more like 10 because you know there's always hidden ones in there. That's why you're going to stay tuned today. It's a very unique routine. Let me tell you exactly what I see in my clinic every day, what I struggle with my patients. Imagine you're standing in front of a door labeled beautiful, healthy skin inside. All you have to do is walk in. On the other side lies a path of diligent skincare routines, healthy habits, and commitment to self-care. In other words, there's a bit of effort here, and you say to me, I'm kind of fine with my skin the way it is. I don't need all that extra stuff. And then you ask this question. This is the one that kills me. But doc, before I go, just tell me one thing. I have one more question. Look at and insert whoever your favorite celebrity is. If it's J-Lo, Dua, Halle Berry, Penelope Cruz, Cindy Crawford, Beyonce. It goes on and on. Whoever you think has the most beautiful skin and looks great for their age, and you say, tell me about XYZ celebrity. Just tell me what they do. That's all I want to know. Well, guess what? I know. I know them. I know what they do. I know their routines and what they go through. They own the hydrofacials, the microderm machines, the glacial facials, the M-sculpts, all the things you want to get done. And for you, it's a $300 procedure, and you try and do one every 3 or 4 months, whether it's budget or it's simply time. We live busy lives, right? You're too busy to go in, but they get them what? Every 2 to 3 weeks. That's the difference. And today, we're going to circumvent that. I'm going to show you how to do it with much, much less money at home with little time commitment, but there is a little commitment. And guess what? It's inexpensive. You see, you don't need to be rich. You just need a tiny level of commitment. They have what we call glass skin. You heard dolphin skin. It means that you have no visible acne, no large pores, no blemishes that stand out, perfect light reflection. To get it, you should have even skin tone and uniform color. Don't worry if that's too much. You don't need fully glass or dolphin skin. You just don't do that last finishing step that gives you that shine and sheen. If you don't want that, that's fine, but you want clear skin. I know that. The reason I know that, people judge you by your skin every day. Sure, some of these will be new to you because I picked them up recently on my travels to Japan and Korea, different congresses. Number one starts with hydration. That's what they do in other countries better than what we do in North America. More importantly, it's not just water, not just any water, but supercharged hydrating water. Now, in my home, I use Kangen water, pH of 9. It's expensive. Those machines are around $6,000. But let's say you're on a budget or you don't want to invest that in your filter. Easy, no problem. Himalayan salt water, often referred to as Soleil. It's a solution made by dissolving that Himalayan pink salt. You dissolve it in water. That pink salt is mined from the Kura salt mine in Pakistan, and it's known for its pink color due to the presence of various minerals, like those mineral baths, the onsen I was going to in Japan, I did a video on the minerals. So to make your own Soleil water, you fill a glass jar a quarter of the way up with this pink Himalayan salt, and then you top the jar with water, and you put a lid on it, you seal it, you shake it up, and you let it sit for about 12 to 24 hours. If all of the salt dissolves after you let it sit, add small amounts of salt until it no longer dissolves. This is a key point. Now, at this point, the water's then fully saturated. When you want to drink it, you don't drink this. What you do is you drop 1 teaspoon of this solution into 1 cup, 240 mLs of water. Now, how do you remember to do this? It's simple. Remember, you have a sleep oasis. When I talk about how important sleep is, you set up your sleep oasis. Definitely watch my video on that. I'll link at the end. But you set your cup next to your bed before you go to bed. As you set your sleep oasis, that cup sits there. When you wake, the first thing you're going to see is not your phone. You're going to get photons coming in from the light outside, and you're going to drink that water. Not 8 ounces, but 12 ounces. You see, we grossly underestimate the dehydration we get from sleep. You may not want to think you sweat, but you do. And hopefully you aren't mouth breathing. Not good for your jawline, right? But you are. Many of you are, at least at some portion of the night. You see, the main component of glass skin is hydration. That's why this is step number one. You're going to plump the skin from the inside out. Make your skin look fuller. You know how I talk about keeping your fat pads healthy? That's a fullness. Well, they are not healthy unless you have hydration. So supercharge it with this method. Now, speaking of nighttime, before you set up that oasis for sleep, we usually cleanse our face, right? Well, the Koreans take this more seriously than anybody. They double cleanse no matter what. You see, a lot of people about my cleanser will say, hey, it doesn't take my makeup off, doesn't just strip everything from my face. I don't want it to. If you have makeup on, if you have a lot of dirt, if you've been exposed to pollutants, you want to especially double cleanse. But the Koreans take it one step further every night. For glass skin, you want to make this a regular process, a regular part of your routine. This is a much more effective way of cleansing the skin without drying it out. And the second step is going to use a cleanser like mine after the oil cleansing. Your first cleanse will be with this oil, and the best oils for double cleansing are those that are gentle and effective at removing makeup impurities without stripping the skin of its natural oils. So you want natural oils. The popular ones that I use with my patients, jojoba oil, cold pressed, almond oil, grapeseed oil, and sunflower oil. Now, these aren't essential oils. These are cold pressed seed oils. I know many of you go, oh, seed oils. There's a bad narrative about eating seed oils and how they're bad for you. This has nothing to do with that. But even if you are on the seed oil kick, don't believe it. Number three is layering. You see, a number one question I get asked is, how do I layer my skincare? What goes on first? What goes on next? You see, you must put the lightweight products on first. Allow those products to be absorbed by your skin and dry before you move on to the next step. That's the next question I get asked. How long do I have to wait between steps? Wait until they're dry. And if they're not dry, that means you're using an oil, and that is your last step always. Unless you're using SPF, that's your final step for sure. But in terms of your skincare routine, light to heavier. You're going to want the best Korean skincare ingredients in one. Keep it simple. You want what I call essence. Essence is a lightweight, water-like liquid that you use as an extra layer of hydration for your skin, and it's the most important step for glass skin because it preps the skin for everything else, all the other products I'm going to talk about. You're going to notice that this is lighter than just about anything you use on your skin. And you want to spray about 4 to 5 pumps of essence on your fingertips and then tap it into your skin. What I rather you do is take the essence from your Korean sheet masks. So if you get a sheet mask, you take it out. What's left in that bag is essence, because essence is on that Korean sheet mask. In mine, I include more essence than you need with the mask. So a lot of people save that for a few days and use that as their essence. Now, here are your top ingredients. I'll leave this screenshot up here for a few minutes so you can take a screenshot of this. And this is what's in my Korean sheet masks, and I spent a lot of time developing them. It was very important to me. All of these are hand-picked ingredients, and mine are made in Korea with all original Korean ingredients. So if you don't want to go through looking what's in your product or purchasing an essence on your own, simply purchase these Korean sheet masks on my site. But if you are using essence, and there's many different types out there, make sure it's pure, make sure it's real, and compare your ingredients to mine. Now, next, for glass skin, the most important and misunderstood layer is the exfoliating layer. You want to chemically exfoliate your skin, common in Asia. Chemical exfoliants work by dissolving, in essence, the dead skin cells that sit on the top of the skin, but they don't damage the skin that's underneath. Now, why wouldn't you physically exfoliate? Well, I'll tell you in a moment the exact way to physical exfoliate, but I don't like face scrubs if you want glass skin, because what do I see on 3D imaging in my clinic from people who are using these exfoliators? If they're too granulated in nature, which is very common, the face ends up with little micro tears, and I can see this on their skin. I don't like that. And no, it's not getting you better absorption. You don't want micro tears to this extent. A great chemical exfoliant that you're looking for is alpha hydroxy and beta hydroxy acids, like in this cream. That's my AHA. And again, you can compare ingredients with what you're using. But you want one that's at least 10% in glycolic, but you want a combination product. Everyone's skin is different, but think twice a week for this product. I do have a blueprint skincare routine. You can watch that video on how often do you use these things, or you can go to quizmd.com, and there in under 5 minutes, answer some questions about your skincare. It comes up with your exact routine for you and your skin type. You don't have to use my products to get this. You can compare your products and the ingredients therein, and you might be on all the right stuff anyway. But it's a great way to know what I would recommend if you walked into my clinic. Tip number 5 is to apply blue light therapy. You want a session of this. You see, blue light therapy reduces acne, pore size, sebum, skin blemishes, and that's what you're looking for clear skin. And because you can do it at home inexpensively, if you think of an LED mask like mine, just take a round number of $400, you're going to have that for years and years. Your cost per use is pennies per use. So it's very cost effective. It's more cost effective than using skincare, because your skincare, you might replace a $100, $50, or $40 jar every 3 months. Work that up over the next 5 years. What are you looking for? Well, bacteria is sensitive to the blue light wavelength. Think 415 nanometers. The bacteria are neutralized by this blue light to prevent them from infecting your pores and causing acne. This, and of course, other effects of light therapy are called photobiomodulation, and it's very well studied. In fact, check out this study. Check out this study in Clinical Aesthetic Dermatology. Well, what did they find? Well, it was a smaller study. They had 21 subjects. 18 were female. And they looked at ones with mild to moderate breakouts for acne. And they had them for 13 years. So these are people with longstanding acne, a very difficult group. And what they found using this blue light, they assessed on day 7 and then day 28. The total number of open comedones or blackheads on the face during the treatment period was reduced significantly on those days. And closed comedones, you guys know as whiteheads, this is the key part, on the face during the treatment period was reduced significantly. The whiteheads are very hard to get rid of, and that's why I'm showing you this study. The total number of papules during treatment reduced significantly, assessed on day 7 and then day 28 as well. When you get whiteheads and papules, forget the acne and the open comedones. This is what leads to people not getting glass skin. So by reducing all of these factors, you're on your way to glass skin. That's how important blue light is. I use it about twice a week, and I use my red and near infrared 3 times a week. Blue light is so easily obtained these days. You need to know and research about not only the blue, but many of these, like my mask, will have red and near infrared. Think 630 and 830 nanometers. An interesting side point, they decrease inflammation at those latter wavelengths. And a lot of people in Asia use these masks. And I'm not telling you to stop using your sunscreen, but they use umbrellas and they use hats, and they're out of the sun quite a bit, but they then don't use sunscreen. Some of them want that white look on their skin, so they'll wear on purpose a white cast sunscreen just to look whiter. But I'll do a study. I'll show you the study on how protective LED masks in the morning are for your daytime UV protection. I think it's fascinating. Keep in mind that many of these LED masks, like mine, will have modes where you can run your blue and red at the same time for you that don't have patience. And that's a 10-minute treatment 3 times a week and study to work. Now, for glass skin, you're really going to want to watch this one up here on slugging. because to get true glass skin, you're going to want to do that at least once a week. And I tell you in that video, the single best product you're going to want to use, and it's under $6. I'll put one down here on oil blading. That's the physical exfoliation that you want to do. It's in this video, my video on skincare treatments to avoid in 2024, but I include oil blading is a positive in that. And I'll put one up here on LED masks. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.